Hi there, this is David Allen for Mac20Q, and today we're going to have a quick look at how we get movies into iTunes. Well, the first thing to do is to drag and drop into iTunes. That's one way of doing it. Let's take this one here and just drag it and drop it over here. So we saw there that it was copying the movie into iTunes. How easy is that then? Go and have a look in iTunes now. This is the one we just copied in there. As soon as you got it in, you can play it. How about that? Quick and easy. Now then, what about if your video that you want to bring in is not a .mov file? We need to have the file set up right so that you can bring it into iTunes and play it. So let's have a look at an AVI file. Here's a file. It's an AVI file. What on earth are we going to do to get that into iTunes? If we take it across and drag it and drop over there, you see it's not getting the box around this area here as did before, so it's obviously a file that's not going to be accepted. So we need to do something with it. So we have a number of options. One would be to use an application called Handbrake. Or we could use Miro Video Converter. Or we could use MPEG Stream Clip. Handbrake is probably the best known of these. And it is pretty easy to use. What we can do is click on Source and go to our folder and get our file and open it up. So we've got some information here about the actual size of the file and so on. Gives us a preview as well. What we want to do is we want to go to some presets maybe. That's the best way to do it. And the best possibility is if you want an iPod file, click on there. Or if you want to, what you could do is go to something like a universal setting, and that'll play on most things. But let's take it as though it was going to go onto an iPad. We've clicked on that, we don't need to do anything else. All we need to do is click on Start. The file was sent into Movies folder, so let's go to our Movies folder. There's our sample M4V now. Let's go back to iTunes, and now we can take our sample M4V and drag it and drop it over there, and that should have been copied in there. Let's have a look, see did it get copied in. Sample, there we go.
I changed it to what?
So now we have our movie in there, we can watch it. How about that? That's pretty good, isn't it? If we wanted to use MPEG Stream Clip instead, drag this into our MPEG Stream Clip application. Let's go to our desktop again, into where our sample.avi is. Drag it and drop it in there. This time what we have to do is we have to go to File, Export to QuickTime. We've got the H.264. Take the quality right up. Put a multipass if you want even extra better quality. And if you want to keep the size within a certain size, then you can choose to limit the data rate. We'll not do that for the moment. We don't need to interlace scaling because it's not coming from anywhere that it's been having interlaced scaling in there. We can change how the sound is in there if we want to. Sometimes I'll put it into an MPEG-4 AAC one there. It doesn't need to be as far as 256. Probably the easiest thing to do, just leave it as it was. And we can tell it to make movie. We get the choice of where it's going to go to. And we'll have it going back to the same folder, into the convert folder, tell it to save. It's taking quite some time just to do one file, and it's gone through it a couple of times. A lot easier using Handbrake. Hooray, it's completed. Let's close that down for now. Here's our sample.mov file. I just changed the name of it, so it's sample 2. And we'll do like we did before, and drag it and drop it over into iTunes. Go into iTunes, here's our sample 2 that we just brought in there. And we can tell it to play movie. And that's still smooching. So that worked for both of those. How else could we do it? Well, we could use an application called Miro Converter to do that. All we need to do is take our original file again, drag it and drop it over into this thing here. So pick a device or video format, and again we're going to say that it's going to go to, let's say it's going to go to the iPod Touch. And this time we're going to have this checked, send to iTunes. Tell it to convert. Job done. That was the fastest of the lot. And this one's called sample.ipod. Seems to have worked just as well as the previous ones, but it did a whole lot quicker.
Changed it to what?
So now what we want to do is we want to see about how do we get those videos that we converted onto our iPod. Let's go to the iPod and we'll go to movies. Tell it to sync movies. You can tell it to automatically include all movies. We don't want to do that. What we want to do is we want to choose the ones that we've just actually brought in there. That was one of the ones that we brought in. Let's click on that one. And the other ones were called sample. So we've got this one, this one, and this one. And as we can see up here, it's syncing those things over to the iPod. And it's copying just one of one. By the look of it, what happened there is the one that we specifically said we wanted to convert for the iPod is the only one that went. The other ones didn't go through. They weren't of the right format. So that's something that you'll need to watch out for when you're converting videos to put into iTunes, and if you want to move them on further into one of your iOS devices, such as the iPod Touch. And don't forget to hit on the subscribe button to subscribe to the Mac20Q channel, and also why not give the like button a bit of a bash too. Thanks very much. Bye-bye now.